Many reactions require a magnetic stirring hot plate.
I'm forgetful, so I'd like one that can be programmed with a consistent schedule. Also, I'd like to do a little cooking and test some recipes. Hey, Chris, from a couple months ago, can I spend $1,400 on a magnetic stirring hot plate? I don't have the money for that. Jeez. Well, guess I'll have to build it myself. Seems straightforward enough. Are you ready to watch me fail? Repeatedly? Because this is 10 tries.
Magnetic stirrers work by rotating a magnetic field to spin a magnetic stir bar in a container. I want to break this issue down into parts. In my first attempt, I tackle stirring. I bought some cheap Teflon-coated stir bars, and for the rotating magnetic field, I designed a setup with a simple DC motor that spins magnets. It is simple and it sort of works, but there's no speed control and the motor wears out the coupler after just a bit of use. Also, it can't spin too quickly, or the stirrer could use a little work, but we'll come back to that. While it may not be an option on many hot plates, I would like some decent temperature control. For the actual heating element, I picked up this cheap single burner for about $12. My control will be a PID temperature controller for another $12. The thermocouple doesn't look like it can be submerged in a solution, so I picked up one that can for about $3. It overshot the set temperature quite a bit, but after it settled, the temperature was very stable. The motor I am using doesn't have much torque, and there's no speed control. So, I printed up a few parts and bought a motor and speed control that is typically used for drones for $13. I designed and printed some parts to mount the motor, measure the speed, and mount the magnets. While this works fairly well as a magnetic stirrer, there's no way the printed parts can withstand the heat of the hot plate. Using the lost PLA casting method I showed in my first two videos, I made these parts out of aluminum. These parts should withstand heat much better. Also, I used my controller from Try 10 of my lost PLA project and made a few modifications. So, it's time to put it all together. I made an enclosure for the control circuitry out of some wood scrap I had laying around and painted it black. Then, I mounted everything inside with some wood screws. I'll be including wiring diagrams on the project page for this project on my site, 10tries.com. I added an accelerometer to help balance the magnet mount so it doesn't vibrate as much while it spins. That process was a little involved, so I'll have to make a separate video for the balancer itself. The device can heat and stir well, so it's time to check the temperature accuracy. To do this, I compared the readings with the freezing point and boiling point of water. I added ice water to a bath and heated it until the boiling point while the Python program recorded the temperature. The idea here is that the temperature should remain at the freezing point of water, 0 degrees Celsius, until the ice melts. Then, the temperature should continue to rise until it is at the boiling point, which should be around 98 degrees Celsius, since I'm doing this test at about 2,000 feet above sea level. The freezing point of water does not change much at different altitudes, because the water density difference is small when freezing compared to boiling. It seems the temperature was only about half a degree low for the freezing point and boiling point. That is pretty accurate. If you'd like to calculate the boiling point of water where you live, I will include the calculator in the project write-up on my site. I'm going to do something that I've never done before. Follow a recipe. I programmed my hot plate to cook some mac and cheese.
The instructions are right.
I wanted to try cooking something a little more difficult. If you've ever cooked hollandaise sauce, you know it is incredibly easy to mess up. Well, precise temperature helps a lot. Alright, so for about $40, the price of some of the cheapest stirring hot plates, I have one that functions similar to a $1,400 programmable stirring hot plate. How would you make this hot plate better? Let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that subscribe button. It really helps me to make more high quality videos.